This vintage Circus poster was being held together by tape. From the late 1930s, we had to put it back together on a linen backing. Watch how we did it today on Poster Fix. Hi, I'm Chris. Welcome to Poster Fix Studio. Today, you're going to see us restore this rather rare Circus poster from the early 20th century.
Look at this. Jack Hoxie, Big Ring, Circus. It reminds me of the old magic posters. It's a lithograph by Milwaukee Riverside Print Company, Chicago. And it's got all these great characters in it. It's a beautiful lithograph. It's got an old banner here that's been torn off, and I have to remove this when I linen back it. Or now. Anyway, it'll come off, and this here, the banner at the top, will be put into place as well. Let's see if this will fit on the screen. Yeah, it'll fit there. That'll work well. I've already got two other Circus posters on this screen. I've got this Ringling Brothers for Dorothy Herbert, and I've got this great Tom Mix poster, a horizontal menagerie of wild beasts of many species. It's a great poster, and there is Mr. Mix. And he's in the mix! So we're gonna linen back this Jack Hoxie poster today, now, on this screen, which has already been prepared with acid-free paper and canvas. And now the poster is going to get added to it. I'm applying the wheat paste directly to the acid-free paper because I feel the poster is a little too fragile to handle having the wheat paste put directly on it. Better to put it on the acid-free paper and then lay the dry poster down on top of it, as I am going to do now. The poster's got a lot of rips in it, so this is a safer way. And I can position it thusly. Now I'm using a roller to push out the air pockets and flatten the creases, flatten the folds. Because as the paper is wet and absorbs the wheat paste and water, it makes the paper more stretchable and pliable. And so what I'm doing is trying to get it as flat as I can through stretching and rolling.
The Jack Hoxie Circus. John Hartford Hoxie was born January 11, 1885, in Kingfisher Creek, Oklahoma Territory. His father was a veterinarian. His mother was a Native American, Nez Pence American Indian. Jack's father died in a horse accident just days before Jack Hoxie's birth. Jack Hoxie was in Wild West shows and was a movie actor who starred in many, many silent film westerns. Beginning in the late 1920s, just after sound film came along, western movie actors began touring with and even owning American circuses. Tom Mix, Ken Maynard, Hoot Gibson, and Tim McCoy, to name a few. The Hollywood western star Jack Hoxie was with more circuses and for a longer period of time than any other actor. Before becoming an actor, Jack Hoxie had competed in rodeos, won the National Riding Championship in 1914, and performed on Dick Stanley's Wild West show. Hoxie's circus career began in 1929 with the Miller Brothers 101 Ranch Wild West show. In 1931, Jack was with the Shell Brothers Circus. In 1933 and 34, the Downey Brothers Circus. In 1935, he performed with the Harley Stadler Show. And in 1936, he returned to Downey Brothers Circus. In 1937, showman Cy Newton persuaded Jack Hoxie to invest in a new circus he was taking out. The title of the show was the Jack Hoxie Circus.
I've got this old Ringling Brothers and Barnum & Bailey circus poster. It has the colossal new spectacle, India. It's really in one sheet, but it's been torn apart along the folio folds, so I've got to put it together on the linen backing. At Poster Fix, where we bring your vintage posters back to life. Sharing the screen with Depeche Mode. A video about.
You want me to paint the whole border or a part?
You can paint the whole border. I don't know. Does it need it all? The bottom needs it.
I think because of the flow, the bold flow, they don't product the discount version.
Discount version of what?
Chicken. The shortage of bird chicken there.
Oh, I see. I put it in the refrigerator.
Another
Jack Hoxie Circus. The circus opened with all new equipment had custom-made trailers and was brightly painted. Although the circus was small for its time, the show made a very attractive appearance on the showgrounds. For unknown reasons, Newton left the circus in July and the show closed for a time. Jack Hoxie brought in R.M. Harvey and the show reopened in late July, only to close again in September, this time for good. After the close of the circus, Jack continued to be a feature attraction on circuses. In 1938, he was back with Downey Brothers. In 1939, with the Lewis Brothers Circus. 1940, Bud Anderson's show. In 1946 and 1947, Jack was with the Mills Brothers Circus. Hoxie's final appearance with Circus was with the Bill Tatum Circus in 1959. Jack Hoxie died of complications from leukemia on March 28, 1965 in Elkhart, Kansas. He was 80 years old. It has been said that Tom Mix was the motion picture superstar of the early 20th century. Although he made the transition into sound films, by the late 1920s, his popularity had begun to decline. In 1929, he joined the Sells Floto Circus as their feature attraction and stayed with them through the 1932 season. In 1934, Mix was with the Sam B. Dill Motorized Circus. In 1935, Mix purchased the show to take out his own truck show, the Tom Mix Circus. Tom Mix's horse, Tony, was used as a pit show. People would pay extra and crowd into a small tent on the midway to see Tony, the Wonder Horse. Tony had also acquired fame, appearing in 181 Westerns with Tom Mix. 1938 was a disastrous year for the circuses. This was complicated by Tom Mix's extravagant lifestyle. The Tom Mix Circus was unable to complete the full season and the show folded in 1938.
Thank you. Where? Yeah, I want you to touch that up. Which one is the other one? Oh, the other one is on the back.
Yeah, this one goes in your
head. Do them both.
The equipment was moved to the Southwestern Stock Show grounds in El Paso, Texas, where Mix was a friend of the sheriff. The show was then sold off. Most of the trucks were purchased by a local auto dealer, Carl Goodman. The tents, seats, and other shows equipment were sold to Patty Coakland, an owner of circuses and carnivals in Canada. Thank you. Well, that about wraps it up for today's edition of Poster Fix. I hope you enjoyed watching my wife and I restore this interesting and beautiful vintage rare circus poster. If you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters or other paper ephemera, get in touch with me. Until then, I look forward to seeing your posters here at Poster Fix, where we bring your vintage posters back to life.